Now will you listen to him in verse 1? Thus saith the Lord, keep ye judgment and do justice, for my salvation is near to come, and my righteousness to be revealed. Now, the prophets recognized that there would be an interval before the establishment of the kingdom. But they also speak of it in the immediate future. And the salvation spoken of here is the national salvation of Israel. And this was what was in the mind of the Apostle Paul when he wrote in Romans 11:26, so all Israel shall be saved as it is written, there shall come out of Zion the deliverer, and shall turn away ungodliness from Jacob. That is anticipation of the coming salvation. And because it was coming, that should be an incentive. You see, just as we've said that if we have the hope of his coming, it's an incentive to live a holy life today. Now he says, blessed is the man that doeth this, and the son of man that layeth hold on it, that keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it, and keepeth his hand from doing any evil. So you see, this is for a people that are back under the Sabbath, and it will be restored after this day of grace in the millennium here upon the earth. And this will be the time of the millennium. Now, today we're living in a day when we're definitely told, let no man judge you, in reference to a Sabbath day. But today, we're therefore not under it, which I think ought to be evident to anyone. But that doesn't mean that God does not intend to restore it to the earth when he reigns upon the earth. For the law will go forth from Jerusalem. Verse 3, neither let the son of the stranger that hath joined himself to the Lord speak, saying, the Lord hath utterly separated me from his people. Neither let the eunuch say, behold, I'm a dry tree. In other words, the Gentile in that day is not to feel he's an outsider because of God's peculiar arrangement with Israel. On the contrary, he's invited to step up and share the blessings. And a eunuch could not serve as a priest under the Mosaic economy. In other words, a physical handicap in that day will shut no one out. Now in verse 4, for thus saith the Lord unto the eunuchs that keep my Sabbaths and choose the things that please me and take hold of my covenant, even unto them will I give in mine house and within my walls a place and a name better than of sons and of daughters. I will give them an everlasting name that shall not be cut off. In other words, the handicap, the strangers and all outcasts are invited to accept God's gracious overture of a position that's better than a son or daughter and a security that's everlasting. Now, the law, of course, could not afford, nor did it give that. This, you see, is lifted now to the nth degree. This is the millennium we're talking about. Verse 6, also the sons of the stranger that join themselves to the Lord, to serve him, and to love the name of the Lord, to be his servants, every one that keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it, and taketh hold of my covenant. You see, the stranger will be given a new heart, that he might love the Lord in that day. And then verse 7, even them will I bring to my holy mountain, and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings, their sacrifices shall be accepted upon mine altar, for mine house shall be called a house of prayer for all people. Now this is a verse from which the Lord quoted when he cleansed the temple the second time. It was God's original intention that the temple was to be for all peoples, irrespective of their race, tongue, class, or condition. And it had long ceased to function as such in Christ's day. Now, the church today is far removed from its primary objective, just as the temple is. The church today has become sort of a suburban country club. And you find that the church has been running from people, either that or chasing them, and not with the thought of winning them to Christ today. But they left the downtown area, went out to the suburban area, and they become there a place that they have generally a good kitchen, and serve a good meal. They have a good volleyball team, and they have a good basketball team. But they don't have very many personal workers that are out winning the lost to the Lord. Now will you notice verse 8, the Lord God, which gathereth the outcasts of Israel, saith, yet will I gather others to him beside those that are gathered unto him. Now the kingdom is to be worldwide in its extent, and it will include members of every family of the human race. And God says in that day they're going to go out after them. I think the greatest time of what we'd call revival, that is turning to Christ, will take place